Hey, this is Nick here with Ally Infidels Airsoft for another review. Well, this is more of an after-action report, like you'll see, two in one. It's an after-action report for the God. Some little crazy NC man's doing, except with skirmish reports. I'm not shipping my gun around the country. It's just, you know, after a game, because it's a new gun. When I get a new gun, I'll tell you how it performs after game. This is a great. Today was Operation Jawbreaker. Part 2, Covenant Form, Long Island. I ran it last night. It was a night op. Me and my squad wound up leaving early. It was too dark. There weren't enough lights. Some guys had tracer rounds. It was only an extra $10 for that. So, you know, we left early. We went back to my buddy's house. And Aaron bought a saw from Steve. So, you know, we're sleeping on Steve's house, crashing. Guess who was up to 4 in the morning with Aaron, fixing the saw, to get it out today? Me. So 4 in the morning, woke up at 6:30, we got in play airsoft today. I'm nuts, what can I say? Anyway, so I'm going to do the game first, and we'll get on to the gun, because I'm doing 2-in-1. So I haven't talked to my girlfriend in a long time, because my phone was broken, and I didn't have a way to talk to her all day, and yesterday, and yeah. So, I guess anyway. The game was not the best. I give it a 7 out of 10. It was good. It had its problems. A lot of people weren't calling the hits. In the middle, a lot of people weren't calling the hits. I had one instance where I lit a guy up. He drops to his knees like this from the flyer, and he stands up and proceeds to shoot me after that. And that was with this thing. I know I hit him. I was about 100 feet away. Just lit up because I was picking people up with semi though. And, you know, it was a good day. Beginning of the day was good. A lot of people calling the hits. We had to take village from Taliban forces. And yada, 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 yada. The night game was just us defending village. And then we would assault village. That's all it was. It was alright. I mean, it was just a pain in the neck. Last night, that's why I just did for attack when we were switching. Sorry, playing with my gun. When we were switching, I said to me, Matt, Aaron, and Steve said script. Matt is our Matt Brady. He's one of our other team members. Eventually, when you see game footage, you'll see him up there. This was the first time in a while, I thought. Right, anyway, so we hit the midday point today. Started to suck. Because we took village, they took it right back. Then we had to take firebase. We had to take firebase, they would take it right back. It takes a long time to get firebase. It's happened about 20 times. Or not 20 times, it's happened a lot though. Rushing in the ASR, the stock, I was using that today. The stock went loose on me, which happened before. So I went back to the car, got the trusty 8K. And I can't really call it trusty because it's a new gun. But yeah, my dad was running the Aries. Large type, taped to the side. Yeah, ghetto. What's your ghetto-ness? It was good. I'm a little tired right now, fatigued. So this may not be the best review for you guys. But yeah. Hey, what can I say? I only had 2.5 hours of sleep running around in the woods all day. But yeah, the gun's all metal. Held up. Excellent. All right, let's get on to the game. Oh, wait. No, I'm sorry. End of the game. The end of the game yesterday. Today. The end of the game today was, what did you do? Oh, yeah. They were retreating to Tora Bora. Right now, it was a battle for Tora Bora, so the Taliban had an oil refinery, had held it for 20 minutes. We drove them out of there. They pulled back to satellite. They pulled back past satellite after we took satellite, and then in Pakistan, we were just taking pot shots at each other for a while, and then they called the game. So it was fun. They won, but, you know. Hey, next time, Northern Alliance has got to win. Right? But yeah, onto the gun. Held up amazing. There's no comparison. It's just, it's crazy. I had the motor really, really high, because I was actually using full auto a lot. I'm not a full auto guy. I ask any of my squad members. I'm a sniper, usually. But this gun is just, this gun's amazing, and if I'm not sniping, I'm using semi on an M4. I always wanted an AK. My dad talked me into the M4. Amazing. This mag is really nice. I did borrow a 600 rounder from Aaron as well, because I was running two mags. You know, that's why I wasn't in the darkest. And Ziggy! Again, that crack did not worsen, so, you know. There's a crack there, it didn't worsen. I'm probably just going to fix it with some wood glue. And then I'll make another stack anyway. So, it's, you know, it is what it is. And, well, I'm going to repoly it, too, and you won't even be able to tell the crack's there. And it's going to get repolyed a bit. Nice hand gun, very not. I'm sorry, man. Yeah, it was a great gun, good sights. I'm gonna be getting an optic for it. It may not be Russian, but it may be. There's a what is called? I think it's called the Alpha. No, it's not. It's not that, but it's some weird unit. They wear Marpet. This is a Russian unit, believe me or not. I'll get the right the stuff from Aaron. If you don't believe me, and I'll shut you straight on that. I'll give you the links to the sites. They wear Marpat, and they actually have AKs. They'll have a rail up here, right here, and they'll have an EOTech on it. Usually black furniture, but, you know, that's that. But that's probably what, you know, we're going to do a Long Island Russian team, probably. Yeah, even though I get my Viper shirt on. Playing back here. Can't really see it well. But, yeah, anyway, I'm tired, so I'm gonna go. And yeah, this has been, I just wanted to let you know, good game, could be run better. Not even run better, it's just Northern Alliance needs to act more like a team. They need to do some structure and they need to enforce the age limit. Biggest problem is 10-year-old kids running around. 12-year-old, 14-year-olds and 13-year-olds who don't know what they're doing. A 14-year-old, yeah, let him in, but he should have to take a course or something beforehand. Should be like a 4-day course if he never played before. Even that, you know. If he doesn't pass the test or something. Alright, that's just my suggestions. Next.